Making a songbook, turn to 353, bottom of the page. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing, blessed be the name of the Lord, the glories of my God and King. Blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Jesus, the name that charms our fears, blessed be the name of the Lord. That's simple enough, ain't it?
Amen.
You know that one?
No.
Well, I'm pulling out some old and new ones tonight. 349.
I've been awaiting, is it?
Yeah.
I've been awaiting.
Anybody know this song?
I've been awaiting.
Because I'll mess it up, probably.
I don't know. All I know is I've been waiting to sing it.
It's a blessing to read the top of that. It says it's the last words of Granny Solomon, oldest old woman on earth, who died in Dallas, Texas, January 11th, 1940. I've been waiting.
Kaylee knows it.
If I mess it up, just follow the way I sing it. Many years I have traveled on this weary road, watch a bleeding changes, tried to share some load. Now my work is finished, steps are mighty slow. I've been waiting, Lord, to go. Getting slow. I've been waiting, Lord, to go. I was going through this song book, I guess last night, and I started songs that I've known my whole life but forgot about are in this book. And the tune started coming back, so I don't know if that's the Lord just getting me ready to jerk me out of here or what it is. Still been waiting. Right? Let's do 358, bottom of the page. Time is filled with swift transition. No.
everybody. Hope everybody's had a good day today. I wonder if anybody have any prayer requests this evening. Just remember that. Be another one. Remember that. Be another one. Remember him. Always need to remember the loss. Be another one. Remember this. There'll be another one. Remember all this. Be another one. Remember this.
They needed to. He just said the same thing. He got that coach. Yeah. Doctor told the family she had to put her on the bench, trouble coming off of it. She's not there yet, but she needs a lot of prayer. Good ladies, they've sung right here before. Several times in the old church. Remember when they pray.
Remember this. Lord can turn that around.
Amen.
There'll be another one. Remember this. There'll be another one. Remember this. There'll be another one. Remember this. Be another one. Remember this. Be another one. Lord knows all about it. It's beauty of the Lord. He knows your heart. There'll be another one. Remember this.
We're living in trying times right now. The day of the Lord is coming soon. Soon in my faith. Coming back after the church. We need to be praying for it. Be convinced these folks that don't know it.
Definitely.
He didn't hold back from us when he put on that cross. He gave his all.
Sure should. Just remember all this. Be another one? If not, how about an unspoken with uplifted hand? Lord knows all about it. Let's take these requests to the Lord, believing he can do something about it. Faith believing. Lord can heal the sick, save the lost. He can do that.
So
he's strong where we're weak. So just pray with faith believing. Stephen, you care to lead us?
Most kind and precious Heavenly Father, God, we come to you today, God. Thank you,
Maker God.
So many blessings you bestow upon us, Lord, for so undeserving of them, yet you still just bless us beyond measure so much, dear Lord. Lord, give us a wonderful service this morning. Lord, the Spirit was strong, dear Lord. And the thoughts all day have been about more about Jesus, and that's what we want to be about in our daily life. We ask you, Lord, to help us, dear God, to walk the walk that we need to do to shine light for this lost and dying world. Lord, forgive us of all the things we do wrong. Don't let us be a hindrance in any way, dear Lord. Lord, we hear to so many once again in our service tonight, God, that needs a touch from you. Lord, we just pray for each and every family there, each and every situation, dear Lord, whatever it is. Lord, the spoken and unspoken, whatever it is, God, we just ask that you'd intervene according to your book, through and blessed will. Lord, you'd have glory in the outcome of everything. Lord, we pray especially, dear Lord, for the lost and such a time that we're in. All the signs, dear God, seem to be pointing to your return. God, we just ask right now, dear Lord, that you give them more chances as you did this morning. Maybe there's one here tonight. You don't know, Lord. We don't know. Sometimes we take for granted, sometimes that, in certain services, that everybody's Christian, but only you know, Lord, who they are. God, we just ask if there's one here tonight that don't know, you give them another chance before it's everlasting too late to come to you.
God, we pray.
Lord, we just ask you now to bless the remainder of this service, whoever takes part in whatever parts play in it, dear Lord. Lord, we just ask you just to honor and glory come from.
Yes, Jesus.
Again, God, we thank you for everything. In Jesus' holy name, Lord, we pray. Amen.
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 If you have. 70.
Y'all are working on you.
B flat.
B flat?
Yeah.
All right.
Don't go home tonight and say.
Don't go home tonight and say.
Yeah.
Up on my heart I have a burden. Calling, don't go home.
Man's glad to be saved.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for everything. I thought a lot today about home. And it's just across the next horizon. We don't know who's going to be next. We don't know if the next big event that takes place on this earth could be the coming of Christ. We don't know. I know I'm ready. How about you?
Amen.
I pray out for those that's not daily. It's good to see everybody that's with us tonight. If you're visiting with us, we're tickled to have you. Let's stand up if y'all want to. We'll fellowship a little bit one another tonight as we sing. On that crucifixion eve, when God's Son was going down, they got up and walked around. It was only 3 days later, after God's Son had gone down, he got up and walked around. Hallelujah, what a promise, and our faith in God is found. And we are buried, we'll get up,
yes, we'll get up
and walk around. Amen. Say good evening again to everybody. Good to see the good number that's coming to be back with us tonight. And we appreciate you in the Lord and love you tonight. Thank God for everyone that's come this way. If you got your Bible, let's go to 2 Peter chapter 3. We'll be in this scripture studying in a few weeks. I had made a note on this scripture some time back and went back and studied it some this afternoon. Seemed like this was the direction the Lord was pointing us in for tonight. And we pray you've had a blessed day, and we hope the Lord has trusted that you've got the rest in the Lord. I came out here earlier this afternoon, picked up the garbage out there in the basement, and we haven't been able to get any dumpsters yet, so I come out and pick the garbage up, and y'all might not have noticed it, but I changed something around in here just a little bit. We brought the offering table back. Next Sunday morning, I think it's time we go ahead and start passing the plate around again instead of just putting it in the back, and it'll be okay. Lord's taking care of us, amen? And not that we don't trust anybody by no means, form or fashion, but just a little easier that way, and we let everybody know, you know, what our services are looking like and how the Lord's blessing us. Amen. I believe that's the biggest number we've had since the pandemic in person. We thank God for that, and God's good. And boy, anything made it better is just see somebody got saved, and we ain't giving up on that. We're gonna keep praying. 2 Peter chapter 3 is where we'll be reading that tonight. If you'd like to stand with us, you can. We'll read the first four verses. And five verses maybe. We might read more than that. I done that this morning, didn't I? It's good stuff. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 1. This second epistle, beloved, I now write unto you, in both which I stir you up your pure minds by way of remembrance, that ye may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets, and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior. Knowing this first, there shall come in the last days scoffers, walking after their own lust, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. For this they willingly are ignorant of, that by the word of God the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water, whereby now the world that then was being overflowed with water perished. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. Thank you, Lord, for your word tonight. Let it lay in our hearts. Let us get better knowledge of it as we read it and study it together. I pray you anoint us, God. We open our mouth, you fill it. Give us the word that needs to be spoken in this place tonight. Let every heart leave here in better shape than it came in. Let not one leave lost. Let not one leave cold and indifferent. Let not one leave sick. Let not one leave troubled. We're in your presence tonight. You're awesome. You can do mighty things. Help us to remember that, Jesus. We love you. Thank you for taking these requests to our Father. Forgive me where I fail. And I pray that all seek likewise. We love you in Jesus' name. His precious name we ask this. And all that wanted said amen.
Amen.
Amen. You can be seated. Thank you so much for standing with us tonight. I like Peter's writings. I go there a lot. 1 and 2 Peter. I get a picture of the disciple and the apostle as he was when he was walking upon this earth. I can see him before Christ, a man that was very willing to do a lot of things. And I can see him after the Spirit was, when Peter's heart was filled with the Spirit on the day of Pentecost. And you see him do great things through Christ. He couldn't do it before. He couldn't do what he wanted to do before. He really wanted to be the best disciple, the best apostle. He couldn't do that until the Spirit filled him. He didn't understand that because he was flesh just like you and I. But Jesus was getting him ready for something. But after Christ, he's just like us. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Amen. Now, I thought about how when he said, I'm writing this second epistle, I want to stir up your minds, your pure minds, by the way of remembrance. In other words, Peter said, I want you to remember something, and I want you to hang on to what I'm telling you to remember. He said that you be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets and the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior. And he said, knowing at first that this first, that there shall come in the last day scoffers, walking after their own lust. There's going to be people manipulate people. There's going to be people tire people down. There's going to be people lead people astray. And they're going to come in and they're going to try to make you doubt the faith. And what did Peter say in that fourth verse? And saying, where is the promise of its coming? I want you to underline that in your Bible, or make a note of it, or highlight it, or however you'd like to do it. Where is the promise of its coming? Because they're going to say, since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of creation. They're going to say, where's he at? If you say he's coming, where's he at? Where is the promise? I want to preach tonight for a few minutes, if God would help me, on I still believe the promise. Amen. I still believe the promise. And you say, preacher, what do you mean? I want to tell you, there is more discouragement out here now in society than there's ever been, especially when it comes to our faith. Amen. The devil is working overtime trying to discourage men and women of faith from trying to do what is the will of God, trying to encourage people, trying to help people, trying to point people toward the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. They're trying to discredit the Word of God. They're trying to discredit the gospel in its fashion. They're trying to discredit anything that the church does. It's almost like what it was when Elijah went out to meet Ahab. Do you remember the statement that Ahab asked him over there in 1 Kings? The statement that he asked him was this: art thou the one that troublest Israel? In other words, Ahab said, you're a troublemaker. You've got all these people trying to follow God, and I'm just out here trying to keep order. And he said, I ain't the one that troubles Israel. You are, amen. Ahab's the most wicked king you ever read about in the Bible, in the days of the kings of Israel. But I thought about how that still today we face that kind of opposition. I want to tell you something, church, that you already know. The devil don't like you, amen. And actually, if you want to put it this way, the devil hates you, especially if you're a Christian. You know why the devil hates you? Because you believed what he did not, and you accepted what he would not. He was in the presence of the angels, and he rebelled against God and tried to be God himself and was kicked out of heaven. Amen. Jesus said, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Amen. He hates you because you're going to be able to enjoy something he's never going to get. Amen. You're going to be in a place that he's never going to partake of. And you know what happiness is, and the devil never will know what happiness is. And let me tell you something. I know it may sound like that I'm trying to paint a pity party for the devil. I'm not. He is evil as the day is long. Amen. He's the author of confusion. He's the father of lies. He will try to manipulate everything in your life. He will try his best to make you to live in doubt. And he wants you to be so confused that you don't know from one day to the next what is going to be the next step, what's going to be the next thing to happen. He don't want us to leave this church tonight as a body of Christ with peace in our hearts, amen. He don't want us to leave with trust in our minds that God's going to take care of us. Let me tell you, I've got my mind made up tonight as a child of God that if I get up in the morning, God's going to be there, amen, because I believe His promise. What do you mean you believe His promise, preacher? He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I will go with you even unto the end of the world. I believe His promise when He said, I hold you in the palm of my hands, and no man. Now why in the world do we fear man like we do when Jesus said, no man is able to pluck you out of my hand, amen. And my Father which gave you me is greater than all, and no man can pluck you out of His hand, amen. In other words, we're held in the hand of Jesus, who is held in the hand of God. I'm telling you, you got big hands around you, amen. And there's nothing going to tire you down. Don't let this world get your head dropped, because Jesus plainly told us to look up, not look down. Look up, because your redemption draweth nigh, amen. I look up because that's where the Father's at. I look up because He's always paying attention, and He's up above you, and He sees what adversity that you face, and He knows what trouble's coming, and He understands what sickness you're going through. That's the reason He said to look up, because I am nigh. I still believe the promise, amen. Just like Abraham that we preached about last Sunday, he believed the promise, don't you think? That God told him, I'm going to give you a son, and I'm going to give you so many that if you can count the stars of the heavens, Abraham, then that'll be able to count the children that's going to come from your loins, that's going to come from the faith that you have in me. And you know what? When Abraham went up on Mount Moriah, he believed that promise. If he didn't believe that promise, he'd have never went up on that hill. But he knew God had an answer in store, amen. Let me tell you something, church. It's okay if your faith has got shaken. Don't beat yourself up if you feel like you've let God down. Remember this. When you're weak, Jesus said, I am strong. When you're down, He's still up. When you're discouraged, He's still in control. And if you look to Him, He's still got the right answers. I come to tell somebody tonight that greater is He that's in you than he that's out in this world. Don't let them knock the breath out of you, because they can't knock the breath out of God. And God gave you His breath, amen. And when He gave you His breath, you're going to breathe forever in God's heaven. I thought about how that Peter said these scoffers are coming. They're walking after their own lust. They want people to listen to them more than they do to listen to God. You want to make people mad at you, you turn a deaf ear to what they've got to say, number one, and they'll start getting upset. Number two, don't fall for the, as the old saying is, don't drink the Kool-Aid, amen. Don't fall for the lies and the hypocrisy that's out there. In other words, don't let what's happening in the world shake you and make you afraid. And when you do that, boy, they just can't stand it. They get so upset. It's awful. They're walking after their own lust. And ever since the fathers fell asleep, we ain't seen His coming. You know what? There was many of them there that Peter was talking about in his day saw the first coming of Christ when He came and He was born in the manger. When He hung upon the cross, they was present at His crucifixion, and they didn't believe it was Him. They didn't believe what the prophets wrote about Him. All the things that He fulfilled, they wouldn't have it. And they're still looking out there waiting for Him to come right now. There's still people in this world right now that don't believe Jesus has ever came the first time. Let me tell you something. When He comes this time, I'm going back with Him, amen. I'm not going to be consumed or tied down or hung up to anything in this world anymore. When the Lord comes, I'm going with Him. Why is that, preacher? Because I still believe the promise. What's the promise? It's written in John 14. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, Jesus said, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. If I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself. He's a coming, amen. He's coming. He's coming. I said He's coming. Are you going to go with Him, amen? I am. I believe that. Anybody else? I believe it with everything in me. There is nothing. There's no news broadcast. There's no biography. There's no newfound philosophy. There's no scientific study. There's no test results that will make me doubt that Jesus is coming back. Amen. He's coming back. He's coming back. It's amazing to me that there is people out there that will say, I don't believe there is a God. I don't believe. I believe it. We just happen to be here. You can go to the doctor and they can draw blood out of your veins. And if you ever paid attention to this, they'll tell you the certain types of vitamins and things that's in your system, the vast majority of them are found right in the ground. You know why that is? Because God formed you out of the dust of the ground. That's why that is. That ain't no accident, amen. Hey, listen, God's the best scientist that ever was. There's never been nobody's better at science than God is, because He created it all, amen. But I thought about how that they said this willingly they are ignorant of. What does that mean? That means they choose to be that way. Listen, I mentioned it this morning, a scripture that's written over in Romans that has said that God would turn them over to a hardness of heart and a reprobate mind. They were so willingly ignorant of the knowledge of Christ, and so much that they had turned Him away so many times that God said, all right, I'm going to let you be what you want to become. What you believe, I'm going to let you become that, and you're going to be engulfed in that. And no matter how they try, they're never going to be able to believe what we preach, amen, because God has turned them over to that, and it has completely encompassed them, and that's what they have become. That's why there is people that is pure evil in this world that we live in, amen. God has allowed them to become that because that's what they desired to be, amen. And by the word of God, the heavens were old, were of old, and the water standing out of the standing, and the earth standing out of the water, and in the water, whereby the world that was then being overflowed with water perished, amen. In other words, what God told Noah I was going to happen, happened, amen. And guess what? After God dried up the earth, and after Noah opened that window and sent out that raven and sent out that dove, and that dove came back with a branch and green leaves, when God opened the door of that ark and Noah got off and made a sacrifice unto God, God put something in the air that was called a rainbow, and the Bible said that that was His promise, that He'd never destroy this earth by water again. God's promise can still be seen in the heavens that we know of as today. I see one just the other day after a rain came through, the sun hit her just right, and I love to go outside after a rain when the sun pops out after a little system, because I know what's going to be out there. I looked out and I see a double rainbow. Let me tell you something. God's double good of anything I've ever noticed or I've ever had or I've ever tasted. Ain't no wonder the psalmist said, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen. But it's still there today because God keeps His promises. Amen. And I still believe the promise. I still believe it. Now let's look at this scripture tonight. I wasn't going to go there, but now I am. Let's look at this scripture. Well, it's found over here. Let me find it, and I'll tell you where to go. Didn't mark it a while ago. Didn't know it was going to go here, but now we are. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Wait a minute, chapter 4. Wait a minute. No, I'm kidding. Chapter 4. Verse 13. Now remember, I still believe His promise. Chapter 4, verse 13 said, I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with Him. I believe that promise. He said, for this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. You know, they may be very well, maybe many of you right here in this church tonight that might be alive and well when the Lord comes. Every one of us might be. You realize that? It may not be the second generation that's coming up after us. We might be the generation that sees Him come. He said, "For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And they which are alive and remain shall be called up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord." In other words, when I go with Him, I'll never be separated from Him ever again. I'll forever be with Him, and you will too. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Chapter 5, verse 1. "But of the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you, for you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness, that the day shall overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of light and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For they that sleep, sleep in the night, and they that are drunken in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for an helmet the hope of salvation. For God hath not appointed us to wrath." Hallelujah. And he said, "But to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him." Hallelujah. He said, "Wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even also ye do." Amen. I want to tell you this. I'm with him now. I'm going to be with him then. Amen. I believe his promise. I know that he wakes up that he wakes me up in the morning. I know he's in my vehicle when I get in there. I know he's in my office when I walk in it. I know he's in my house when I lay down. The Lord is everywhere with his children, amen. There's nothing slipping through the cracks on Almighty God. God has not just saved us to keep us out of hell. He saved us to make us part of the kingdom of heaven, amen. And as we grow and together in faith and truth in Christ Jesus, let's believe his promises, amen. They're wrote from the front to the back. They're this deep in the Word, all the way from Genesis to Revelation. This is a promise book that God wants you to be with him, and that God has a plan for you. And if you put your life in the hands of Almighty God, you'll understand what I'm saying when I say I still believe his promises. Amen. I've got something back here. Let me see if I can find it. All right, somebody play that commercial again as we take a short break. With me, that's okay. I've got a little book. Everybody hold your song books up. About that thick. That is nothing but promises. No man's opinion. No sermon notes. Nobody's study on it. From front to back of that book, all it is promises. Now hold your Bible up in there if you got it. Taken out of that right there.
Amen.
I thought I had it back there. I was looking for it this evening. I found another book I forgot I had, and it's got me curious. Now I've got to get into it. God stirred my heart on something. Whew. Can't wait on that. But anyway, it's wrote. All it is somebody took promises of God to us out of the Bible and wrote them in a book. You can find it probably on Amazon or on Lifeway or somewhere like that. It's called the Bible Promise Book. That's all it is. It's just promises out of the Word of God. Can I tell you that God promised unto me when He saved me that I'd have life everlasting.
Amen.
That I'd have joy unspeakable and full of glory. I get distracted sometimes. I get hurt sometimes. I get frustrated sometimes. I get sad sometimes. But every one of us have the ability as Christians to do like Paul did when he went on trial before Agrippa that day. You remember his answer? He said, I thank myself happy that I may be able to speak for myself today. In other words, I'm happy because I've got Jesus with me. Amen. Anybody happy because I've got Jesus with them? Amen. You know, you have the ability to think yourself happy. You have the ability to remember what God's... That's the reason we encourage you so much to get in your Bible, especially in this day and time. Get in your Bible. Read it. Study it. Let it not just don't just get in your Bible. Let your Bible get in you, amen. Let it go out in your eyes and right into your heart and let it burn in there. Boys had a good study Wednesday night out of the two chapters right before what we just preached out of, the 2 Peter chapter 1, about the seven things that God adds to faith. And I'm telling you, we had a good time. God's word is pure and it's true, amen. And it's here for us. Ain't no wonder David said, it's a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. In other words, it's helping me to walk. I believe His promise. Amen. Amen. Now God said, and I'm believing this promise, and I believe several of you are as well. There was a man that was a jailer one time that Paul and Silas was in his jail. And you know, when he sprung in there at night, called for a light. Right, here's the light he called for. Amen. Of course, he needed natural light to see, but they had this light in the prison with them. They had the Word of God, the testimony of Christ, the gospel. He called for that light and he said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they told him, if you believe in the Lord Jesus, you can and your house. I'm believing God's going to save my house.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know how many grandchildren I'll have if the Lord tarries His coming. I have no idea. I believe God's going to save my house.
Amen.
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 Do you believe God's promises?
Amen.
And don't give up. Don't get discouraged if they ain't been saved yet. Amen. Keep praying. Keep believing. And let God be God. Bible said let God be true and every man a liar. Let God be God. Maybe you're here tonight and you say, preacher, I don't know. I want to believe what you're saying, but there's just so much discouragement. There's just so many things that disgust me. Why are people sick? Why are they troubled? Why does children face this? Why do they face that? Can I tell you something? God knows what's happening. He ain't ignorant to what's going on in this world. But can I tell you this as well? God ain't going to make you do nothing. He's not going to make you believe in Him. He's not going to make you be saved. But He'll give you a choice, friend. And He said, choose you. Joshua told him like this, choose you this day whom you're going to serve. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And we need a lot more households that says, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Amen. Now, I want to say this, and I wasn't going to say anything about it, it makes me nervous even bringing it up, but we get a song invitation. I'm going to say this. And I want you to hear me tonight. And I believe you're going to agree with me when I say what I'm about to say. Are y'all nervous yet? Because I am. No, I ain't nervous. I'm just going to tell you the truth. What happened at the high school in Hazard the other day was not all right.
Amen.
It was not all right. If what we see is what happened, it was not all right. If you're taking children and turning them to the things of the world like that, it's not all right. Where did it start at? We don't want that hanging in our school. Where did it start at? We don't need this red in our school. Where did it start at? You ain't praying around on that school property no more. They've got so lazy they won't even say the police is a flag anymore. Buddy, when I went to school, first thing we done in the morning is the teacher was in there praying. Second thing we done is we drug ourselves up out of that chair, no matter if it hurt somebody's feelings or not, and we put our hand on our heart and we said the pledge to the flag. And we didn't care whose feelings it hurt. way I look at it, if you don't like it, there's other countries to live in. That's just my opinion. Get shot tomorrow, I guess. Y'all can come to my funeral this week. It'll be all right. Can I tell you this tonight? There's things that's happening in this world that ain't all right. Amen. They can say that with such education. I tell you, that's pure sorriness is what that was. Now, if you see me doing that out with a bunch of kids, what would you do? I hope you kick me out on the curb next Sunday and say, you better get yourself straightened up, young man. No, it ain't all right. It ain't all right. I've got a Bible full of promises. And it tells me if I'll pray, faith believing, I'll receive that that I asked. So you know, what can we do about these situations in the world, Preacher Shane? You know what we can do right here at Letterbox tonight? We can say, God, will you intervene? Will you intervene for these young people that feel like or that are pushed into doing things that are uncomfortable because they feel like they've got to do them to fit in? Will you show them, God, that you're not there to fit them in, you're there to take them in and to raise them up and to save them and to love them and show them what all life is about? Can I tell you tonight, friend, that you'll never know love till you know Jesus? And when you get saved, you got love for the brethren. How do you know you've passed from death unto life? You got love for the brethren. There's a love that come in your heart unlike anything else. I was talking to a fellow this morning as you stand to your feet. He had an uncle that was rough all his life. Abused his wife. Would bet money between his boys to see who'd whoop each other when they was grown men. Just hard and as hard as you get. About a week before he died, he made a profession of faith. And the man I was talking to was his nephew, and he said, you want to know why I believe he really got saved? And I said, why? He said he called his family in and started telling them how much he loved them. He said they had never heard that in their life. Never. His boys had never heard that. His grandchildren, his wife. He hadn't told his wife he loved her in 30 years. He began to tell them with tears in his eyes how much he loved them. God makes changes in people. You realize that? God makes changes in people. I was talking to a man about that this morning. His uncle had been dead for several years. He was telling me that story. You know what the promise is tonight of God? If you'll let Him come into your heart, He'll make you a brand new creature. That's a promise I believe because I've experienced it myself. You're not looking at a perfect man. You're not looking at a man that'll ever be perfect wise on this earth. You're looking at a man that's full of faults and failures. But I'm also full of something else. His Spirit. And it tells me what's right and it tells me what's wrong. And it shows me the path that I need to walk. And I believe His promises. I believe He's coming. And I believe He's going to take care of me till He gets here. And if you're discouraged tonight, try God. Because He'll never let you down, as we say. Try God, He'll never let you down. Call in the oppressed. Come to me and rest. He said, where two or three are gathered together in my name, I'll be in the midst of them. I believe that promise. He said, as two or three are agreed, is touching anything, it shall be given unto them. I believe that promise. I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. And learn of me. Jesus said, learn of me. Hear me and be blessed. I'm meek, I'm lowly. Come and trust my might. Come, oh come. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. Come, oh come, while there is time, while the Lord is calling. Come, oh come. Bring your case to Jesus. He'll give you rest. Come unto me. I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Hold you. Hear me and be blessed. That's that song I was talking about. That's a good
one.
Jesus said, come, learn of me. Learn of me. What's he saying when he says, learn of me? Well, the more I learn about him, the less I worry about this stuff out here. Amen. God's awful good to me. I don't deserve what he's given me. But I come to tell you tonight, I still believe his promise. And I pray you do too. You know, when he asked Martha, when he looked at her and said, your brother will live again, he said, do you believe this? And she said, I believe that he'll live in the resurrection at the last day. And he looked at her. He said, I am the resurrection. And I am the life. Though he were dead, yet shall he live. But it's powerful words. I still believe he is the resurrection. I still believe he's the life. I believe he's the way. I believe he's the truth. I believe he's the life. I believe everything that's written in this book about my Savior. And ain't nobody changing my mind. Amen? I just believe it. And you know what? I thought about this. The Bible says not to cast your pearl before swine. If there's somebody so hard-nosed that they don't believe the gospel, don't sit and argue with them. It ain't going to do no good. If they've been turned over to a hard heart, don't throw it out there to them. I ain't telling you not to witness to people, but there's some people on this earth is never going to believe in Jesus Christ. I want everybody to be saved, don't you? And God does too. But when people turn and turn and turn and turn God away, it's coming. It's coming. Amen. Well, I hope we see many saved here. Amen. It's good to be here tonight. Maybe somebody has testimony, something on their heart. Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody else.